Music can be a rallying call for a lot of people, and it can keep people company through their highs and lows. A rock band after school activity is a prime example of this, and the members are just as eager to listen as they are to play. I interviewed three members of rock band, plus a supervising teacher, about their music tastes and how their participation in playing might have affected what they listened to. I firstly interviewed Christina Sim, a former rock band member who now lives in the US.
So in middle school, I played the drums, and in high school, I played the piano, and I sometimes sang with the main singer.
Christina was definitely adept in playing a lot of instruments, and it definitely makes sense that she would search for songs that highlighted what she was good at.
My favorite song is, it's called White Noise by Cass. I recently discovered it through my sister.
The song was upbeat and groovy, but soothing at the same time. According to her, performing songs on stage that she wasn't familiar with, such as Lucky Strike by Maroon 5 or Ain't It Fun by Paramore, helped her become more fond of other songs of those genres, and helped broaden her taste in music. Then, I went to Ray Park in 11th grade.
I have experience of playing the guitar, drum, and keyboard. I also sang for 4 years. My favorite song so far is Rain On Me by Lady Gaga and Ariana Grande. It's good.
Rain On Me is a great song for all audiences to drive to, and the impressive vocals in the song are reflected by her skills in singing as well. Additionally, Rain On Me also seems to show how rock band opened her up to different genres of music. Next, Mr. Hutchings, one of the supervising teachers and advisors for rock band, offered his insight.
Well, I was in a rock band growing up. I was in rock bands throughout middle and high school. I really enjoy the group aspect of it, making music together with a group of friends. And you know, growing up, that was the genre that I listened to the most. When I first came, that teacher had left, so there was like an opening for a second rock band teacher to help out. And I thought, hey, you know what, I'm a music teacher and I really like rock bands and I think I might have something to add. So I ended up joining up and helping out.
It seems that his taste in music wasn't as deeply changed, but there is charm and consistency, too.
It's a band called Rave Cries Against, and the song is called Savior. And it's like this really fast-paced, kind of punky, rocky song. And it's like, these days, I'm listening to that song a lot because I just really like the feel of it, and it's very energetic. And it's like right in that range where, like, if I were to sing it, yeah, it feels really good. Like, I would want to sing that song kind of like, yeah. But I can tell you that like last month it was a good song, or a couple months ago it was a good song.
While I personally don't listen to a lot of rock songs, it's definitely fitting that Mr. Hutchings would be so avid about the genre. Savior is a great song, and its lyrics are sad but inspiring, definitely worth a listen. While he did recommend only one song per my request, Mr. Hutchings demonstrates that it's okay to not be so sure about your favorites. One day you might like this, then another day you might like something else. As long as you're happy with what you're doing, sticking to one thing isn't always necessary. Last but not least, I interviewed McKenna Jolly, another member.
In Ardelia's rock band, I play the guitar. At the moment, I really like the songs Looking Out for You by Joy Again and Black Sheep by Metric.
Hello again, friend of a friend, I knew you were. Our common goal was waiting for the world to end.
Unlike the three songs mentioned before, Black Sheep is featured in a movie titled Scott Pilgrim vs. the World and covered by its actors. The song itself sounds lively and almost dangerous. McKenna's optimistic approach to letting discussion among her teammates was apparently important to influencing her taste in music, and it shows a great advantage of having different people express themselves to each other. It was really insightful to get to know how music players found different songs and had an impact on each other. This isn't just something that applies to those that play music. Sharing songs is a great example of exchanging ideas and changing each other for the better. I'd like to thank Christina, Ray, Mr. Hutchings, and McKenna for participating in this video.